Hello everyone. In the last session, we have seen three variable Carnot map. In this session, we will solve some examples of four variable Carnot map. Let us see the examples. This is the representation of four variable Carnot map. See, as I told you, four variable Carnot map in the sense there are four variables, therefore you will get 2 to the power of 4, that is 16 cells. See, here we have 16 cells into the four variable K map. Look in this direction. So we have in this direction 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So similarly in this direction we have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So this cell represents 0. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So these are the decimal representation of a particular cell or particular square box. Now, with respect to the problem, depending upon the decimal value or the minterm list, we have to enter the 1 into the appropriate cell. Let us see this example. Simplify the following four variable equation. Now, k is equal to f of w, x, y, z. It is equal to sigma 0, 1, 4, 5, 9, 11, 13, 15. The first step is to enter ones with respect to these decimal values. This has been already entered. 0 is entered with 1. So similarly 1, next is 4, 5, next is 9, 11, 13 and 15. So as usual, our next step is to loop the group of ones. As we have discussed in the last session, always the group of 1's have to be in the powers of 2. So it can be 2 to the power of 1, 2 to the power of 2, 2 to the power of 3, 2 to the power of 4 and so on. And always you need to consider the maximum number of 1's. See here, these 4 1's can be grouped together like this. So this is one group. Similarly, this is another group. And these four ones can also be grouped together. This is another group. With respect to each of the group, let us try to write the expression. The expression for this is, it is the same procedure you have to follow. See, the inputs are W, X, Y, Z, MSB is this side and LSB is this side. The variable which is changing, that has to be eliminated. The variable doesn't change, that has to be kept. See here, W is as it is. This is also 0, this is also 0, whereas X is changing from 0 to 1. That has to be eliminated. So since this is 0, this side you will get it as W bar. Similarly, this side you get it as Y bar. So for the group 0, 1, 4, 5, you get the expression as W bar, Y bar. Similarly, let us write the expression for this. W is not changing, whereas X is changing. Since W is not changing and it is 1, write the expression as W. And this side, if you see, Y is changing whereas Z is not changing. Therefore, it is W into Z or W and Z. This is the expression for this particular group. So similarly, let us write this. See, we have four ones like this, which covers the entire row. Therefore, all these will cancel out and we get the expression as Y bar Z. Now you need to find out which is the essential prime implicant and which is the prime implicant. See here, this group is EPI. This is also EPI. What about this group? This is prime implicant PI. See, this prime implicant, that is 15912, it is not an essential prime implicant because none of its main terms are unique. Whereas if you see this, it has the unique main term, and if you see this also, it has the unique main terms. Therefore, these two are the essential prime implicant and this is the prime implicant. When you write the expression, you get it as K is equal to essential, first essential prime implicant is W bar Y bar, or next essential prime implicant is WZ. This is the expression, minimized expression for this particular example. Let us see the next example. Reduce the following equation using the 4 variable K map, and it is given as L is equal to F of ABCD, it is equal to sigma 0 to 5, 7, 8, 10, 13, 15. As usual, our first step is to mark the ones into the K map. So this is with respect to 0, next is 2, next is 5, 7, then 8, 10, 13 and 15. So next step is to group the variables, group the min terms. So how can we group this? See, this is 4, it is usual. So these 4s can be, 4 ones or 4 min terms can be grouped together. In the K map, this one, this one, this one and this one can also be grouped together because they are logically adjacent. Therefore, we can group like this, this one, this one, this and this. So this entire thing makes a single group of 4 ones. So there are how many groups now? This is one group and this is the another group. And this side is MSP, this side is LSP. Let us write the expression, and both are the essential prime implicants. Now what is the expression for this? The expression for this is, if you see this side, A is changing whereas B is not changing. This is B. And if you see this side, C is changing, D is not changing. So you get it as BD. And this is the essential prime implicant EPI. Now see this. See, all these 4 ones are into the single group. You have to consider this and this. So here A is changing from 0 to 1 whereas B is not changing. Therefore, we can write it as B bar. Similarly, if you see here CD, C is changing whereas D is not changing. We say it as it is D bar. This is also the essential prime implicant API. Now what is the expression? Since both are essential, we have to include that into the expression. Therefore, we can say it as L is equal to B bar D bar or BD. So this is the expression for this particular K map. What you have to remember here is, always you need to consider the maximum number of ones into the group. See, all these corner ones can be grouped together in the K map because they are logically adjacent. And accordingly you need to write the expression and finally the final expression. Let us see the next example. Reduce the following equation using the four variable k map. P is equal to f of r s t u sigma 1 3 4 6 9 11 12 and 14. So first step is to mark the min terms into the k map. This is 1, then 3, then 4, 6, 9, 11, 12 and 14. So all these are marked. Now you have to see how we can group. See, I told you top and the bottom lines are adjacent. That is, this line is adjacent to this line. So similarly, this and this cells are also logically adjacent. Therefore, since they are logically adjacent, we can group them together. We can group like these two ones and these two ones together. So similarly, we can group these two ones and these two ones together. Let us write the expression. So the expression for this would be, for writing the expression you need to follow the same procedure. And again you have to see which is the LSB and which is MSB. This is MSB and this is LSB. So 0 to 1 is changing and S is not changing. Therefore, the first literal is S. Similarly, if you see this side, you have to compare this and this. So T is changing whereas U is not changing. So you get it as S U bar. And this is the essential prime implicant EPI. Now what is the expression for this? You have to consider this and this. R is changing whereas S is not changing. Therefore this is S. R is changing, S is not changing. So you get it as S bar because it is 0. And this side, if you see, T is changing whereas U is not changing. You get it as S bar U. And this is also the essential prime implicant. Now what is the final expression P? P is S bar U or S U bar. And this is nothing but, this is S exclusive U. It is XOR gate. Therefore, the minimized expression for this particular minterm list is S exclusive U, which is equal to S bar U or S U bar. See, we are looking into how we can group various ways or different ways to group the ones. See, here we have grouped like this, these two groups and these two groups. In the previous example, we have grouped all the corner ones. So depending upon where exactly the min terms, in which appropriate cells the min terms are available, accordingly you have to group the maximum number of ones. See this example. Reduce the following equation using four variable k map. D is equal to f of w x y z. It is equal to sigma 5 7 8 9 and 13. So again, first step is to mark the ones. So let us check that. This is 5 7 8 9 and 13. Next step is you have to group. Let us group all. This is first group. This is the second group. This is the third group. And this is fourth group. Now let us write the expression for each of the group. Consider this. Now, what is the expression? Here, it is a single column, so it has to be W X bar. And this side, if you see, Y is constant, whereas Z is changing, so it has to be Y bar. W X bar Y bar. Now, what about this group? One is constant, that is W is constant, whereas X is changing, therefore it is W this side and Y bar Z. Next is this group. See here, it is W is changing, whereas X is constant. Test to be X and Y bar Z. Now writing the expression for this. This side W bar X, Y is changing and Z is not changing. Therefore, we write it as Z. So W bar X Z. Here, in this case, you have to find out which is the essential prime implicant and which is the prime implicant. You will get two solutions for this. The first solution is by grouping. Let me change the color of my pen. The first solution is by grouping this one, that is this one. Next is this and this. See, this one can be grouped either in this loop or in this loop. So if you consider this, you will get one expression. If you consider this, you will get the another expression. So let us write for this particular case, this group, as well as this group. See, first we will write which are the essential prime implicants and which is the prime implicant. This is essential prime implicant EPI. What about this? These two are the prime implicants. This is one prime implicant and this is another prime implicant. Whereas this one is essential prime implicant. So I told you this one either can be covered in this group or it can be covered in this group. If you consider this group, you will get one solution. If you consider this group, you will get the another solution. So let us write by considering this group, that is this one, this and this. Let me write the expression D is equal to, with respect to this group, W bar XZ. Then with respect to this group, that is X Y bar Z. Then with respect to this group, that is W X bar Y bar. It is one solution because we have two prime implicants. The other solution is D is equal to, let me change the color. What we are considering now, leaving this, we consider this group, then this group, and then this group. When we write the expression for this, we will get the solution of another group, we will get another solution for the same combination of the main term list. Then we write it as W bar XZ, that is with respect to this group, then W X bar Y bar with respect to this group, and this is another group, that is or W Y bar Z. So we have two solutions. This is one solution and this is the another solution. So by grouping in different different groupings, we will get the different solutions for the same minterm list. It will be Consider the next example. Reduce the following equation using four variable Kmap. P is equal to F of ABCD. It is equal to sigma 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 12, 13 and 14. So our first step would be to check whether all ones are entered in the Kmap. And you see which is a LSB and which is a MSB. This is MSB and this is LSB. First is 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 12, 13 and 14. Now we need to form the groups. And always we have to consider the maximum number of the ones those can be grouped together. See, look here, these are the 8 ones which can be grouped together. So we can group all these 8 ones together. Now this row and this row, they are logically adjacent. Therefore you can group these two ones and these two ones together. So similarly you can group these two ones and these two ones together. Following the same procedure, let me write the expression for each of the group. See, if you see this big group, so all these will cancel out. You get it as only C bar. Similarly, for this group, A will cancel out B, and here C will cancel out. You get it as D bar. And for this group, here B will cancel out. B is changing, whereas A is not changing. Therefore, A bar. And in this, C is changing and D is not changing. Therefore, you get it as D bar. And all these are the essential prime implicants. We have seen already the discussion of what is the definition of the essential prime implicant. At least one min term should be unique for that particular group. Then it is known as the essential prime implicant. Therefore, all these three groups are the essential prime implicants. We can write the final expression as P is equal to C bar or B D bar or A bar D bar. See, here you have to notice is how we can group the min terms. So depending upon how you group, accordingly you will get the minimized expression. If you group the maximum number of the ones, you will get more simplified expression. So if you make the small groups, then your expression becomes big and it won't be simplified. Coming to the next problem. Reduce the following. S is equal to F of ABCD. Sigma 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11 and 15. First step is, notice you can see that this is 1. That is, 1 is entered over here. 3 is entered over here. Then 4, 5, 7, then 8, 9, 11 and 15. Then make the grouping. See, these four ones can be grouped together. These four ones can be grouped together. Similarly, this can be grouped together. And this can be grouped together. You write the expression. This is A bar, B, C bar. For writing the expression, you need to follow the same procedure. This would be A, B bar. This is C is constant. Therefore, it is C bar. And this would be A bar D. This CD. If you observe this, all these are the essential prime implicants. Therefore, all are to be included into the final expression. We can write it as A bar, B bar, C bar, or A bar, B, C bar, or A bar, D, or C, D. This is the final expression. Coming to the next problem. Determine the prime implicants and essential prime implicants for the following. The given problem is U is equal to F of WXYZ, which is equal to sigma 1, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 15. Let us check whether all are marked into the K-map. 1, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13 and 15. Here in this case, we need to find out which are the prime implicants and which are the essential prime implicants. First, let us mark these four ones can be grouped together. These four ones can be grouped together. These four ones can be grouped together. Similarly, there is one more grouping prime implicant, which is this one. These four ones can be grouped together. Now here we will see which is the prime implicant and which is the essential prime implicant. Let us write the expression for this. This is W X bar. So this is essential prime implicant. Now what is the expression for this? It is W is changing, X is not changing this side, Y is changing, Z is not changing, therefore it is XZ. This also is the essential prime implicant. At least one unique mean term has to be present into that particular group, then it is the essential prime implicant. Now coming to this group, coming to this horizontal four ones, coming to this group, all these will cancel out. We get it as it is Y bar Z. This is also essential prime implicant. Now if you consider this blue colored group, what is this? Is it essential prime implicant or prime implicant? The expression for this is W, this side it is W, and here it is Z. This is prime implicant. So in this particular example, we have three essential prime implicants and one as the prime implicant. Our expression now becomes U is equal to W X bar. We need to consider all essential prime implicants. W X bar, Y bar Z, or X Z. This is the expression for this particular example. And we have three essential prime implicants and one prime implicant. We have seen the various examples of four variable K-map and how to minimize or simplify the expression using four variable K-map, and also how to find out what is the which one is the essential prime implicant and which are the prime implicants. We will see in the next class. We will continue in the next session. Thank you.